Kagan, Maggie was placed on leave from this detention center in May after a coworker reported suspicious conduct between her and a teenage boy. But she might have never faced criminal charges if she hadn't confessed to the affair 3 months later through Facebook messages she sent to a coworker here who happens to be a former sheriff deputy who turned her in. 9 days before Maggie Stastny was arrested on a child sex assault charge, we went to her home knowing she was under investigation and asked her husband about a car she had loaned to a former juvenile inmate at the Marvin Foote Youth Services Center.
I'm trying to find out if she ever reported Isaiah for stealing her car.
Nope.
Never did.
It turns out Maggie had supposedly sent Facebook messages to a coworker at the Marvin Foote Detention Center seeking his advice. A former kid kind of stole my car, but I can't call cops as he has blank on me that could get me arrested. Maggie reportedly goes on to say the kid with her car knows about her affair with another former inmate. I definitely slept with him, Maggie writes to the coworker, who happens to be a former Arapahoe County Sheriff deputy. The former deputy asked Maggie why she had sex with the juvenile inmate. He's persuasive. There has to be more. Not really. When are you getting your car back? I don't know. Blank has it. Then was asking for money to get it back, now isn't replying. I have my gang friends dealing with it. Based on those Facebook messages, detectives interviewed Maggie, who confessed to having sex with a juvenile inmate in the boys' restroom of this Denver library and in the parking lot, and that she had given the inmate money, clothes, and multiple phones while he was at the Marvin Foote Detention Center. And according to the affidavit, other kids in the pod had tried to get drugs from her after telling her that they knew what had occurred. One kid tried to extort her via Facebook, writing, "If you care about being free, you better give him $20,000. Now, we don't know for sure who was shaking Maggie Stastny down for money, but the affidavit implies it might have been that boy who borrowed the car from her, not the boy she was having sex with. The Cherry Creek School District informed Maggie back in April they were not happy with her. They were not going to renew her contract when it was up in June. Then they placed her on paid leave in May. That's when those allegations of sexual conduct first surfaced. Reporting live in Centennial, Rob Lowe, Fox 31.